Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you different types of blockchain and their respective examples. So let's get started. So broadly speaking, blockchain can be classified into three categories. One, public blockchain, two, private blockchain, or third, consortium or hybrid blockchain. In this video, we'll be understanding each type with an example. Number 1. Public blockchain. Simply said, publicly accessible blockchains are termed as public blockchain. Further, these blockchains have no restriction on the participant and the validator. Also, the main advantage of this type of blockchain is the uncontrollability of the blockchain, which means that nobody will have the complete control over the network. Hence, it ensures that the data is secure and helps in immutability of the records. Also, all the nodes connected to this public blockchain will have equal authority, and hence, this public blockchain becomes fully distributed. Bitcoin and Ethereum are some of the examples of public blockchain being used in real-world scenarios. Number 2. Private blockchain. As the name suggests, this particular blockchain requires the participant to be invited before they can be part of the blockchain. Here, all the transactions are visible only to the person who are part of the blockchain's ecosystem. These type of blockchain are centralized and much better controlled than public blockchains. As the blockchain are more centralized here, they can be governed and regulated by someone who can make sure that the governors are guiding participants. Also, these blockchain can have a token or may not have one and can be manipulated based on the preference of the blockchain owner. Private blockchains usually have a network administrator who can take care of the user permission in case any particular user requires additional authority on the go. These are typically used in private organizations to store sensitive data about the organization. For example, Hyperledger. Number 3. Consortium or hybrid blockchain. Now, this blockchain can be divided into two different types, where some nodes are private while others are public. As a result, some of the nodes will be allowed to participate in the transactions while the other nodes are supposed to control the consensus process. This comes out to be as an ideal hybrid blockchain between private and public blockchain. Here, all the nodes can be accessed by the blockchain, while the level of information that can be accessed will be based on the node accessing that particular data. In this blockchain, there are usually two types of users. One is the user who has all the control over the blockchain and decides the level of security for a particular user, while rest others are the ones who just access the blockchain as per their function. For example, Ripple Network. So, now let's answer the biggest confusion. What is the difference between blockchain and cryptocurrency? Well, the difference between cryptocurrency and blockchain is the same difference between mobile application and your mobile platform. For example, the app can be WhatsApp or Uber, while the platform can be iOS or Android. In the end, the applications will run on the platform, and in a similar tone, blockchain is the platform while cryptocurrency is the application. This confusion is quite common as both cryptocurrency and blockchain were introduced at the same time with Bitcoin. And do remember that Bitcoin was the first application of cryptocurrency on the blockchain platform. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, be sure to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.